Joining me today are Mr. Utsa and Mr. Siddhant, the two core members at Rocket Learning. Rocket Learning was launched in March 2020 with the aim to provide an equal education foundation for early learners. The initiative has already reached above 1 lakh students and 10,000 plus teachers within three states of India.
Rocket Learning, first of all, the name is very catchy. How did you all come about the name for Rocket Learning?
For inviting us, completely our pleasure. So two reasons. One, it's a catchy name, as you said. So we were looking at a name that resonates with children. Since a lot of our work is with children, we were looking for a name that resonates with parents. And I think the core mission is to take children ahead, and you know, at as fast pace as possible. Hence the name Rocket. It just seemed to combine everything.
So, you know, talking about your programs, how did you all make the teaching learning process interesting and, you know, and interactive between the students and maybe, you know, involving the teachers and parents? How did you all come about doing that?
And once again, thanks for inviting us. So, very good question. I think we try to make our content as easy and simple to understand to both parents as well as the teachers. So, ideally, like a parent is seeing a video, it should not be very long, it should be small, catchy, to the point, and should have something like a call to action towards the end and what is expected out of them. Also, we try to make it in as much regional languages as possible. For example, if you are working in Aurangabad, then the content will be in Marathi. We also try to make some non-educational campaigns every month or every few weeks, which is some sort of, you know, fun activity that the parents can do with their children and the teachers can do with their children to kind of make sure that the engagement keeps going. So I think, just to give you an example, we recently launched a campaign that says, you know, aap bade hoke kya banna chahte hain, and the kids had to draw or make up or, you know, pretend to be something that they wanted to be. It can be anything, right? We want, you know, that creativity to be there across activities.
As we all know, this COVID has created such a huge disruption, especially in the education sector. Has the work of Rocket Learning been affected by it in any ways?
Good question, Shannon. So I think when we started, and we started thinking about this about a year previously. So just as a background, a lot of us have worked in education for several years, and we strongly believe that working with children is super powerful, right? In terms of return on investment, in terms of the effort that's put in, extremely powerful segment to work with. So when we were thinking, we were conceptualizing of a program where we work with parents at home, how they can work better with their children and educate them better. We were also envisaging a program where we work with schools and with teachers and you know, support the in-school program and like a at-home program as well. With COVID, you know, a lot of our focus actually was parents, and that received, like, let's say 100% of our focus post-COVID, as again working with teachers in school as well. So it's anyway something that we wanted to do, but I think in terms of focus, that actually received all our focus. And we're in a way very thankful for that. Of course, children have had a tough time in the past year in terms of their learning. But from a long-term perspective, I do think that, you know, the last year has been good to involve parents, and the overall realization that a blended learning model of some way, like in school plus at home, is critical for children.
Absolutely. So talking about involving parents in the activities based with children, how did you all do that? You know, do you all have an app for it, or did you all, you know, come up with something online technology kind of?
Yes,
Go ahead.
No, you start, I'll then add.
Yeah, I think, Shannon, we leverage WhatsApp. The reason being that, you know, the parents that we serve with, we work with, are mostly from low-income communities, and we have to keep in mind their sort of tech savviness, tech readiness, as well as access to the technology. Thankfully, I think in India, especially in rural India, I think the smartphone and WhatsApp penetration has gone up significantly in the last couple of years, from about 40% to upwards of 60%. And that's something that we want to make sure that our solution works at scale. Now, in order to make it work at scale, we need to have it accessible by as many people as possible. That's why we want to use something which people are, which parents are familiar with. That's one. And of course, you know, that increases the access to the technology itself. And then, you know, the content kind of gets sent automatically through our technology on these WhatsApp groups, right? So every morning in that teacher-parent WhatsApp group, there'll be a video to say that, you know, parents, this is the two small videos that you have to see and kind of get back and upload the same on WhatsApp group only, which just makes it easier for parents.
Yeah. Exactly, as Singh was saying, I mean, the one app that literally everyone has, everyone with an access to a smartphone is WhatsApp, right? So all of our tech has been built upon WhatsApp. And which is why we see, you know, and we'll talk more about numbers later on, but generally the uptake to the program, the kind of responses, the number of people that we're able to serve today is, you know, I think WhatsApp has played a very, very large role.
Of course, and especially with this COVID situation and being at home, WhatsApp is one, you know, go-to for everyone, be it rural or urban. It's like a very interactive and a very quick solution. That's
exactly.
Great. You know, following up on that itself, apart from WhatsApp, did you all use your YouTube channel? Since you all have a YouTube channel, did you all use that to reach out to students, you know, in, you know, creating videos that would be interactive or maybe, you know, something that they would learn from, also, you know, enjoy? Because as we all know, a child's attention span is very limited, and especially being at home with all the distractions around.
It's really interesting, Sharon, actually. So I'll start, Siren, and then please add. So when we started off you know, we did pilots in April last year, and then we started our first program in Chandigarh and Aurangabad in June last year. You know, our content actually that we built out is completely digital, right, in nature. So it's very short in nature, like 2-3 minute videos, exactly as you're saying, right? The attention span is low. And it's important to keep in mind that our content is directed towards parents because, you know, they actually facilitate and work with their and educate their children, right? So we typically send 2-minute videos, very attractive in nature, very engaging, with a call to action, right? Where we also ask parents to actually do the activity and then share it back on these WhatsApp groups. But that's one part of it. Second, you know, more closely related to your question is, how did we use YouTube or other forums? So when we, again, you know, there's a lot of orientation that we need to do with teachers and parents when we start off. And we use YouTube, you know, YouTube Live, especially as a very, very strong way to engage with teachers, because typically thus far, before COVID, all of these trainings were done physically. And I think everyone woke up to the you know, remote nature of doing this as well. And we did trainings and orientation sessions for like 1,000 teachers, 1,000 Anganwadi workers at one go, which we actually found extremely much more powerful than we'd also anticipated. So that's how we leverage some other forums as well.
Oh yeah, coming back to, again, online technology. How were the parents' reactions to, you know, how y'all came about doing this? Were they on board, or did y'all have to convince them to, you know, join on board?
So definitely, I think parents, this is basically, you know, the reason why we work with this solution with governments is because it just makes it easier to onboard parents. So if a government school teacher or an Anganwadi teacher is the person who's onboarding them, then I think it works better. Of course, we still need to do a lot of convincing to the parents, right? We still need to provide that sort of aspiration as well as motivation. So I think there are two ways that we approach it. And one is, you know, if there are parents who are doing well, make sure that they are rewarded, right? Or they are recognized with, like, it can be small smiley report cards or digital medals that they get, or appreciation to the teachers as well. And if there are parents who are not that active yet, we try and find out what is the root cause and how can we help them best. It can be through the teacher. It can also be through some tech interventions that we take a bill that, you know, can we send a personalized message to them saying that, you know, you were doing really well, can you continue doing the activities? Aap jitni activities karenge utna aapke bacche ke भविष्य के लिए अच्छा होगा, सिंपल मैसेजेस विच विल रेजोनेट विद देम. सो दैट्स हाउ वी अप्रोच यू नो गेटिंग पेरेंट्स इनकल्केटेड इनटू दैट हैबिट ऑफ यू नो स्पेंडिंग दैट 15 20 25 मिनट्स पर डे विद देयर चाइल्ड.
Right, so it was like motivating the parents along with the students. That's nice.
Correct. Shannon, can I add something if that's okay? Yeah. Sorry, I know you have a list of questions, but
no, it's okay.
So just adding on to what Siddhant was saying, there is a model that we follow with, especially with parents, or a framework that we follow rather, which is called AIM. The first, like, A stands for awareness. You know exactly what you were asking, because I think that part is extremely important, that we do through, let's say, you know, mass level campaigns, we do through more localized campaigns, right? So that's one part of it. Second is the content part, which is information, right? What kind of content are you sending out? What are you receiving back? I think the two-way part of information is very important, not one way, but also hearing back from parents. And third is the motivation part. A lot of that is done through constant measurement. So we share report cards, certificates. We will add more about that later. But I think the AIM framework is something that has served really well with, you know, with the audience that we work with.
Right. I seen that on your website as well, and it was quite interesting. Again, now we've been talking about various states, and you'll have you'll have reached out in 3 states as mentioned. What are those 3 states like? Where have you all marked your land or landed your rocket rather?
So as I said, you know, we're actually working in Chandigarh. So not us, like, you know, obviously the Union Territory, and then we're working in Maharashtra, Aurangabad and Mumbai. So Aurangabad district with the Anganwadis there. In Mumbai, we're working with the municipal corporation. With the Balwadis, and we're working with a chain of schools across Mumbai and Pune called Akanksha Schools, Akanksha Foundation, and we are working with the UP government, in a focused way in 5 districts, while our content and some of the media work that I was just referring to earlier, some of the mass level communication, that's actually going out across the state.
Okay, that's great. So considering, you guys are already working within Punjab and other regional states, you know, now NEP has come up and NEP will be implemented soon, and it has actually started implementing already. So, one of their key focuses is vernacular content and regional languages. So how will that affect, or any of the other, NEP programs would be affecting Rocket Learning's existing programs, or are you already aligned with what is going on?
Yeah, I think at a high level, Shannon, the NEP does lay a lot of focus on foundation learning and literacy, which kind of aligns with the work that we have been doing. For example, in UP, we are working with grade 1 and 2, where making sure that foundational literacy and numeracy outcomes are achieved is one of the key sort of metrics that we are also aiming to improve. So in a directional sense, the NEP really helps. From the one place where we also are focusing more, which even NEP has mentioned but not that much, is the parent engagement bit. Because for early years, I think just making sure that the parents are also involved will require a stronger policy and advocacy push as well, which through our work and if results show that parent engagement is working, will be sort of an add-on over and above what NEP says for early years. So that's like a couple of points from an NEP point of view and how they impact our work or how they sync up with our work. What's up to add?
Yeah, I completely agreed, sir. And Shannon, just to add, actually the NEP is very, very powerful, right? And I think not only for early childhood, I think of course with the first five years that we also focus on, the NEP also envisages exactly the same model. And we're obviously very, very excited about that. I think in addition to the early childhood model, I think the FLN mission is also, which the NEP talks about, is also extremely exciting. And I think the mission might be launched, maybe sometime this year. I think which focuses on a lot of foundational literacy and numeracy and Shannon, again, vernacular language. So all of our content, actually everything is in vernacular language, is contextualized. you know, for the local area. So actually, it doesn't affect our program. In fact, it helps us in several ways. So it's exactly in sync with the way we had envisaged the entire program.
That's really awesome. So you don't have much to, you know, work around it because you're already working with it. How is Rocket Learning aiming to reach any other states, or you know, what are your future projects, future plans?
So, Chandan, you know, we're obviously working in the three states that we're currently in. I think we've actually received incredible support from all of these, state governments / district governments, right? So we definitely want to work further in the states that we are in. And let's say in UP, we've got incredible support. So we do want to expand in more districts in UP in a more focused way again, right? So that's one. We are looking at a couple of other, let's say, states, Hindi-speaking states especially, because we do have a lot of content built out in Hindi and Marathi. Again, all of this content is completely open source and available for anyone who finds benefit in using this. But we are looking at Hindi or Marathi-speaking states right now to expand in. We have some conversations going with a couple of states. So that's one. And, so it could be, again, I think it's premature to name the states until something's. But we'll definitely be looking at expanding in the current state that we work in, and maybe starting in one or two more states this year. Again, this is both across, foundational learning, and as well as to some extent the early childhood system as well.
Great. That was about the expansion. What about the new projects? Do you all have any, apps coming on the way, something related to Rocket Learning, maybe some Rocket app or something that would, make kids more interactive and something that we could also, as, educators look forward to?
Yeah, a lot of new features, but actually let Siddhan talk about it. He's been working a lot on features as well. So, yeah.
And over the last few months, we've been working across these three sort of geographies that we mentioned, right? We just made sure that we do a lot of innovation in terms of the technology that we are offering. So we try multiple things to see which is kind of giving that engagement or activation for parents, and then we try to make that into a technology feature. Just to take an example, I think if you are a parent and you have a child and you send six videos in 2 weeks, right, of that child. Now we are working on a feature which will kind of combine all these six videos and make it into a collage and send it back to you. So you can almost see, how your child has been doing across those videos, in one playful sort of video. It can also serve as you can see your child's growth. You can also kind of enjoy watching your child doing all those activities together, right? This is like one of those examples where our technology will do it automatically for around 1 lakh kids who are already tagged to us, right?
Shannon, a lot of our focus has obviously been in to build out features, right? Like our tech stack. So let me just sort of talk about what we built and what we are looking to build, right? So we built out a messaging platform where today we're working with 10,000 plus schools / Anganwadis. We can actually send out whatever content we want at the click of a button to all of these schools, right? All of the WhatsApp groups of these schools. So there's no issue in, cascading down or being unsure whether content has reached, anyone or not. That's one. Secondly, we built out personalized nudges for getting parents activated, getting parents more engaged in the education of their children. Third, what we've been working a lot on is also, the measurement aspect that I was talking about. How we can actually track what parents are doing, how regularly they are doing. So we actually send report cards, completely automated report cards every week to parents. We send them medals, we send them badges, certificates on good performance. And again, it's very, very important to realize that all of this is 100% automated. So, it also ensures scalability, it ensures accuracy, it ensures parents are excited about the program, children are excited. So it ensures all of that. Going forward, we'd obviously like to build a lot more of these engagement features, right? So we built out like technology, which we're actually just testing out last week, where, you know, everything that parents do actually get, you know, come into a collage in sort of a video, and a parent can see what their child has done over the last 1 month or last 2 months, right? Similarly, some of our features that are being built are, you know, how do we conduct assessments, or how do we conduct quizzes on these WhatsApp groups, on these school WhatsApp groups? So a lot of these areas are what we are focusing on, right? Again, a new app is not necessarily in our mind right now, because we do believe that building technology upon WhatsApp is the way to go, at least with the audience that we work.
No, I think just to add a little bit, I think we've already mentioned the features, but basically all these features have come across, you know, from a lot of trials and sort of innovative testing that we've been doing over the last few months. And the focus of, you know, the next wave of adding more technology is to make the experience of the parents and the teachers more engaging. I think that's, so it in a sense, Shannon, to your question, I think it's not about probably another app in the short term, but it's about making the same experience more deeper and more engaging for the users who are already there.
I think that's it for today. I have just that many questions. Once again, thank you so much for joining and great knowing so much about Rocket Learning. And we definitely look forward to what you guys have in store and where other states the Rocket will